I'm Megan Likes, and I am the founder of Bookkeeping Academy Online and Likes Accounting Company, and the co-owner of Jeff Likes Clean Windows and Gutters. And I am here to show you how to do bookkeeping like a boss in 20 minutes or less. I'm so excited to share this topic with you because it's really a passion of mine. I love helping home service businesses, especially those in the cleaning industry, understand their numbers. Understand how to use those numbers to drive better decisions so that they can have better businesses. So today, not only going to show you how to do your bookkeeping like a boss, but here's the three takeaways that I want you to win out of today. One is I want to show you how to make your taxes a breeze. It really shouldn't be a chore that takes you hours and hours every year to get everything together. And it shouldn't be something that you dread. It should be something that you look forward to. So I'm going to show you some of my secrets for making your taxes a breeze every single year. I'm going to show you how to do your own bookkeeping in less than 1 hour every single month. And I'm going to show you how to run an audit-proof business. I don't like it when business owners are terrified of making decisions that are important for their business because they're afraid of being audited. So I'm going to show you today, really quickly, in the next 20 minutes, how to do all three of those things. And I'm so excited. So let's dive in because we don't have that much time. So the first thing that I promised you was I said I'm going to show you how to make your taxes a breeze. And I know that that sounds funny. I probably didn't mention this in my intro, but I'm a CPA located in Northern California. I'm a tax accountant. I love taxes. I'm a tax geek. I'm actually the tax accountant that says that I want you to pay more in taxes, which I know sounds very counterintuitive, but bear with me. The reason I say I want you to pay more in taxes is because that means that I'm going to show you how to make more. And the best way I'm going to do that is by showing you how to leverage your numbers, how to understand your money, to know where it's coming from and where it's going all the time. So I want to help make your taxes a breeze. And the easiest way to do that is by setting up your bookkeeping systems to support you when it comes tax time. So I know a lot of business owners that do like the shoebox method, or maybe they've outsourced their bookkeeping and the tax accountant doesn't, like, I have so many times somebody will come in my office and they'll say, oh, I just send my P&L to my tax accountant. And I want to show you how to set up all of your expenses so that tax time comes really easy. And your CPA is only going to have to do a little bit of their CPA magic where they wave their magic wand and everything's going to be dialed in and super seamless for your tax preparation. So the best place to start is in your books with your chart of accounts. And I know I'm the accountant, if you don't know me, I'm the accountant who talks more about feelings than I do about numbers. And when I say words like chart of accounts, usually people's face falls and they kind of hide under their desk. But that's not where we're going with this. I want you to begin with the end in mind. So I want you to get to know your tax return. So I'm going to give you some takeaways. I'm going to give you some homework. And one of those is I want you to pull out your tax return. I want you to actually look at it. So you do your bookkeeping, or you have a bookkeeper who does your bookkeeping. And then what does the CPA magic actually look like? Are the books that you gave your tax accountant what ended up actually on your tax return? So I want you to take a look at that. So you're going to find your tax return. You're going to pull it out. If you are a sole proprietor, which means you're an individual who files your business taxes on your individual return, you're going to look for your Schedule C. Now, if you're a single member LLC, same thing. You're going to look at your individual tax return for your Schedule C. Your partnership, you're going to look for your 1065. If you're an S corporation, you're going to look for your 1120S. So find your tax return. Go find your tax return. I want you to open it up. I want you to find where your business is on your tax return. Because people think that it should be pretty straightforward, but it's not. That's why CPAs make a lot of money. We call it job security. The tax code is really, really, really thick, and the tax laws are very, very difficult. So what you think you're doing year-round with your accounting and with your bookkeeping isn't necessarily what's getting translated onto the tax return. So I want you to find your tax return and take a look at it. Now, some things that are really interesting when people do this exercise is they're surprised to know that on your tax return, there's only one line for your gross business income. I'm going to say that again. There's only one line for your gross business income. So if you're in the cleaning industry and your tax guy is doing your tax return, he does not care what are one-time cleans. He does not care what are residential cleans. He doesn't care what's commercial cleans. He doesn't care what was your biweekly or your monthly cleans. All those different income categories actually never make it onto your tax return. On your tax return, all that's there is your gross income, the total number. Another really interesting thing is on the Schedule C, which is the most common type of business tax return, there are actually only 19 lines for different types of expenses. 19 lines. Sometimes people will come into my office and they'll bring me their bookkeeping and they're so proud of it. And I pull up their chart of accounts and it's 5 pages long. 30 lines per page, that would be 150 different categories that they're categorizing every single month, every single transaction, trying to scroll and find the right category. So I like to remind you to begin with the end in mind when you're setting up a bookkeeping system or when you're cleaning up a bookkeeping system. And simpler is better. Fewer is better. The less transactions that, the less categories you have, the better. You're gonna wanna try and keep this really usable and simple. And a great place to start is by looking at your tax return and looking at all those categories that actually end up on your tax return. Now, most of us can't keep all of our categories for our cleaning businesses down to 19. So the IRS does give you an extra 10 lines on the second page. Now we're up to 29 categories. And you can always do a statement. So what I'd like you to do is get familiar with how your CPA has been categorizing your transactions. Because if you're one of those businesses that has 150 different categories in your chart of accounts, I guarantee you, your accountant is charging you a lot of money per hour to do their CPA magic and consolidate some of your numbers. So I want you to make this simple. I want you to make it usable. Another rule that I like to use when I'm setting up categories in a bookkeeping system is I want you to think about if it's a regular thing. So sometimes my clients get stuck in the weeds when it comes to utilities. Do we really care what percentage, like what dollar amount for the year was spent on gas versus electric versus water versus trash versus internet versus telephone versus fax line versus your security system? I mean, is that really gonna help you operate a better business? And if you're doing your books correctly and you're putting a payee for every single line, we could get that information based on the name of the vendor. You don't actually need a separate category for each of those different types of expenses. So think about your books, think about your chart of accounts. Just because it's the way you've always done it doesn't mean it's the best way. And think about how you can simplify the number of categories that you break up all of your expenses into every single month. Fewer is better. And if you need help, I do have a free chart of accounts download that I'm happy to share with you. You can find it at bookkeepingacademyonline.com/small-business-chart-of-accounts. And you can find that free chart of accounts download so that you can set up your chart of accounts the way I set up chart of accounts as a CPA for thousands of home service businesses across the US. Okay, takeaway number two, I'm going to show you how to automate your workflows, and I gave you a really big promise. I said, so you can do your bookkeeping in less than 1 hour a month. I didn't say 1 hour a day. I didn't say 1 hour a week. I said 1 hour a month. So how the heck am I going to make this promise? Well, it's really just two simple words, and they're quite brilliant, actually. QuickBooks Online. Now, I did not say QuickBooks Desktop. I said QuickBooks Online, because QuickBooks Online says that if you are a QuickBooks Desktop customer and you convert to QuickBooks Online, you will save between 10 and 40 hours every single month worth of work. And if you follow the methods that I'm about to share with you, I think it's going to be even more than that. And here's what they've done with QuickBooks Online. And I know you might be sitting there. I get this at every industry conference that I speak at, every home service business owner that I meet, they push back on me. I know you might be sitting there and saying, that QuickBooks Online thing, that's not for me. My accountant, they don't like it. They don't recommend it. My accountant says, if I do that, they're not going to work with me. I hear you. I see you. And here is my case that I am going to argue for why that accountant is wrong and why you should reconsider. So back in the day, like 15 years ago back in the day, QuickBooks Online was not a good product. It was not robust. It was very simple. It was a little clunky. It was super slow. And it did not do everything that QuickBooks Desktop did. Let's fast forward 15 years to 2020, the year that will never end, the year that continues to go on and on and on. In 2020, QuickBooks Online does absolutely everything that QuickBooks Desktop does. Every year I give a talk like this, I say, well, except for this thing, well, except for that thing. In the year 2020, I'm saying it does everything, all of it. Everything that you do in desktop, you can do it online. So if you're sitting there saying that won't work for me, I'm telling you, you're wrong. Now, the only exception for why I feel like people should stay in desktop, which is becoming less of an issue, is if you have more than 50 employees and you're using QuickBooks Desktop Payroll, it is going to be very expensive for you to move to QuickBooks Online or to another payroll service provider. So the desktop payroll package is a very good deal, but the desktop product is not a good deal because it is now the archaic version. So in the beginning, the accountant said that QuickBooks Online stunk. Well, they were right, it did. But now I'm telling you desktop stinks because QuickBooks Online has so much AI built in. They have spent millions of dollars developing really smart software. So let me tell you what I mean by really smart software. In QuickBooks Online now, you sync your QuickBooks Online file very securely, completely encrypted, with your bank. Your bank pushes to QuickBooks Online every single time you're swiping a debit card or a credit card or writing a check. The bank is going to tell QuickBooks Online that information. Gone are the days where you're paying somebody to enter click, click, click every transaction that you're swiping, every transaction that you're spending. That's not a thing anymore. Now the bank is pushing all that data to QuickBooks Online for you. It's pushing the date. It's pushing the vendor. It's learning from you that this vendor is always going to be this category, and it's pushing the amount. It's really quite amazing, and it's really, really fun. So I love those automations in QuickBooks Online. And in June of 2019, those automations went to the next level, and QuickBooks Online introduced these things called rules. And rules are where it's going to learn from you. Every single time you pay AT&T, QuickBooks is going to automatically categorize every AT&T transaction as telephone. Every single time you stop at ARCO, QuickBooks Online is going to automatically categorize it as gas or fleet gas or fuel or something like that. It's going to learn from you. It's really, really, really amazing. And it gets even better. ARCO Gas, so I own a window cleaning company. Not sure if I shared that with you. And ARCO Gas is sometimes not gas. Sometimes it's ice, because where we live, it's 110 degrees during the summer and we have to buy ice. Well, I can create up a QuickBooks Online rule that says when I buy stuff at ARCO and it's less than $10, I want you to auto-categorize that as supplies. And when it's over $10, I want you to auto-categorize it as fleet gas. Now, my QuickBooks Online, I'm just going in because I pay the same vendors essentially month after month. The same people get my money, and I'm usually spending it on the same stuff. It's very rare that I will spend money with this vendor and buy a completely different category. That doesn't happen very often. You set up these automations, you set up these rules, QuickBooks Online is learning from you, and pretty soon you're getting into your QuickBooks file and it's taking you 5 to 10 minutes a month for a $1 million business to do their bookkeeping. You heard me right, 5 to 10 minutes a month to go through all those transactions because there's all of this AI in there. So bank syncs are really, really, really awesome. Them pushing that data into you, QuickBooks Online learning from you is really, really awesome. And when the bank's pushing the information into your QuickBooks file, it makes reconciling your accounts, ooh, another big scary accounting word, but when it makes reconciling your accounts so much easier. It really makes it a breeze. So I love bookkeeping like a boss in less than 20 minutes because I have all of these tools in my wheelhouse. And don't be the guy or the gal that's sitting there that's like, ugh, I can make desktop do that, because you can't. And I try. I've tried, but you can't. Okay, my third promise to you, and we are flying through these 20 minutes, but my third promise to you was I wanted to help make you build a business where you're not afraid of getting audited. I want to help make you audit proof. And I want to do it paperless, because I don't know about you, I'm pretty sure you're probably like me. I own a window cleaning company that is mostly in the field. It is a field service business. And I feel like every cleaning company I know is also mostly in the field. Now, I know you might have an office, but that office is hopefully organized, right? Hopefully it's a space that's keeping your supplies and not all your paper. Because for me, what drives me crazy, and I own 6 businesses, so it really drives me crazy because that's too many. That's too much volume for me to have to deal with the paper. So I love running paperless businesses because the mail used to kill my soul. So for each of my businesses, I only keep 3 paper files. 3 paper files for every business. And I keep them any place I get mail. So if it's at home or if it's at the office or if it's at the shed or wherever it is, I only have 3 paper files. And I believe in keeping everything. So don't get me wrong. I am not like the shredding queen. I'm absolutely a hoarder. But I figured out how to organize my businesses so that if I were ever audited, I would have all the documentation that I need, and I'm doing it paperlessly. So do I have your attention? I hope I do, because sometimes this is people's favorite part, because if you're like me and the paper is killing your soul, you know exactly what I mean. You can't get your hands on it. You spend all this time filing. You never seem to have enough room in all the file cabinets and all the places, and the paper comes in and it's like a mountain and you're building a fort, the whole thing. So we're ditching the paper. I'm gonna show you my three file system. So first paper file, to do. Second paper file, to scan. Third paper file, to shred. So simple. To do, to scan, to shred. That's it, my three paper files. Okay, full disclosure, I do have a firebox in every location. That's for the very, very, very important paper documents that I cannot shred. But it's a very small firebox, it's about this big. So I'm limited on my capacity of how much paper I can keep. So three paper files, to do, to scan, to shred. To do, what goes into do? Can you guess? Anything that needs to get done. So I'm a big fan of the book, Getting Things Done. And in the book, Getting Things Done, if it's a less than 5 minute task, you should just do it. Just get it taken care of. So when I'm opening the mail, if there's something that's gonna take me less than 5 minutes and I have the time to do it, I will just get it done. If it's gonna take me more than 5 minutes, I put it in the to-do folder. This might be a baby shower invitation. Because we're talking about, it's all mixed up. Personal life and business life, it's all a mess, right? This might be a baby shower invitation. This might be a raffle donation solicitation. This might be a worker's comp audit. This might be an insurance bill. So whatever it is, if I have to do something and it's gonna take me more than 5 minutes, I put it in my to-do folder. And I deal with my to-do folder once a week, twice a month, it kind of depends. But it goes in my to-do folder and it just sits there until I have to actually do it, right? And these are really thin files, super thin files. I should have brought them in here so I could show you. Okay, if I don't have to do anything with it, like let's say it's like a recurring automatic payment thing, my goal is to get those turned off. I don't like getting the paper. I don't like getting the mail. But if I do get the mail and I can't get the statement electronically any other way, then it goes in the to scan folder, okay? So when I'm going through my to-do folder and I'm doing all of my to-dos and making sure I'm staying on top of all the paper, when I'm done with them, I mark them. Like if it's a bill I had to pay, I mark it paid. I say which account. I say what date it was mailed. And then it goes in my to scan folder. Now, my to scan folder is not as thin as my to-do folder. It can get like really, really thick because both my husband and I hate scanning. And if I want my staff to scan it for me, I have to take it to the office. And it's not super intuitive how to scan. So I'm still working on that system. But to scan folder builds up and then we just sit down and we scan everything. And we organize it online. So we scan it one by one. I name all of the files with the date and the vendor, that way I can find it either way, and I save them online. So you can save your files in Google Drive. You can save your files in Dropbox. If you need to save your files securely, you can use some sort of secure server. I use Citrix ShareFile. That's where all of my secure documents go. And I organize my scans by the name is the date and then the vendor, right? And I put those in a folder by year. And then I can find anything I need at the click of a button. And when you're using Google Drive or Dropbox, you can find it from anywhere in the world. So I keep a handle on my paper. My only bottleneck is I don't scan every day. I scan probably once a quarter, but I have naming conventions and I store it all virtually. Now, let's talk about those pesky receipts, because if you're anything like my husband, which if you own a field service business, you probably are a little like him, you might have a center console hiding somewhere in your work vehicle that has a bunch of receipts. Or if you're like me, because I try and be cute, I keep my receipts in a jar and they get jammed in the jar. Okay, so let's talk about the pesky receipts. So QuickBooks Online, remember? That was the secret key to number two. QuickBooks Online is so stinking amazing. And QuickBooks Online will actually automatically track your receipts for you. So you open your QuickBooks Online app with your cell phone, you take a picture, and are you ready for this? It's so exciting. You take a picture and it is going to recognize the name of the vendor, the date, and the dollar amount. And then it's going to search your QuickBooks Online file and it's going to find the matching transaction. Then all you have to do is click match and it will attach that receipt image to your transaction in QuickBooks Online. It will store your receipts for you with no extra charge. It will match it to your bank register, no extra charge, And now you're officially audit proof, because when you go to get audited, you run your profit and loss statement, which you have set up to match your tax return. If the auditor wants to look into any of it, they can click into any of those items. Okay, I'm a CPA, but I'm not your CPA, full disclaimer. I'm not recommending that you give your QuickBooks Online file to an auditor. But hypothetically, if you needed to get any documentation, you could click into each of those transactions and find the receipt for that one line, for that one transaction, or for an entire category of transactions. And all of that data can be exported in a zip file at the click of one button if you were to ever leave your relationship with QuickBooks Online, which I cannot imagine why you would, because I freaking love Intuit and they save me so much time and money. But that's how you would make yourself audit proof. That's how you can run a virtual paperless office. That's how you can get out from all of the terrible, terrible paper that is just weighing down your soul. Okay, so as a refresher, we just went through 20 minutes of bookkeeping like a boss. We did it in 20 minutes, and here's what I told you. I told you that you can make your taxes a breeze. It does not need to be a chore that's done once a year. If you set up your chart accounts correctly and you begin with the end in mind, your taxes can fly by. You can absolutely do your own bookkeeping. There is no rocket science here. QuickBooks Online has made it very foolproof and easy. It's very hard to screw up, and you can do it in less than 1 hour a month. There's no excuses there. And you can set up your business to be paperless and audit proof, where you can store all of your documentation and all of your receipts, and you don't have to worry about 3 years from now, the IRS questioning some transactions, because you're gonna have it all detailed and documented. And my name is Megan Likes. I'm the founder of Bookkeeping Academy Online. I love helping small business owners build more profitable businesses, because I educate and empower you to know your numbers to drive better decisions. And I'm very happy to have spent these past 20 minutes with you. I hope that you found it useful. If you did, please check out that chart of accounts guide. It will be really helpful for you in getting your chart of accounts organized and starting to think about how you want to set up your different categories in your QuickBooks Online file. And again, my name is Megan Likes with Bookkeeping Academy Online. Have a very great rest of your day.